brake knockoff is the reason you often see in racing when drivers are approaching a corner after a long straight, they end up having to pump up the brake pedal before they'll actually start working. So you'll often see when the cars are heading down the straight towards a braking zone, you'll see the brake lights flash from the outside before the actual braking marker. And that's the driver pumping up the brakes before they get to the braking zone. Little pump of the brakes, not a big application, just usually a couple of small pumps. And that squeezes the pads up against the disc, not so much that they start braking, but just that they're prepared to brake. So when they do want to hit the brakes, they can go in one go and the car will start braking. So we're looking here at a pretty typical front brake setup. We've got the brake caliper, the disc, and the pads. So if we look in there, you can see in behind the pad, between the caliper and the pad, we've got these little pistons sitting in here. These pistons are the parts that push out from the caliper onto the pad and squeezes everything in together there to make the car stop. So what's happening when you get brake knockoff is the pads themselves are getting pushed back into the caliper. And that means you end up with extra clearance in between the pad and the disc. You need to use an extra brake application before the brakes actually start working. The number one thing for reducing pad knockoff is to reduce compliance and any play in your hub and upright. So that can mean at one extreme, simply adjusting the wheel bearings if you've got an adjustable type wheel bearing, or it could mean increasing the stiffness of this whole assembly. So the hub and the upright, making sure that you're reducing the amount of compliance that they've got, and that can mean an entire redesign. Here, looking at this caliper on the bench again, we can look at a couple of other ways you can look at reducing knockoff. So quite a common thing is to use anti-knockoff springs. Before the caliper is assembled, you put a little spring in there behind each of the pistons, and that just keeps a little resistive force, just so when they're at rest, they're constantly wanting to move out towards the pads. It's normal to build the calipers specifically for each circuit in professional racing. So you'll have at some circuits, say, a relatively low average speed circuit with lots of bumps and curbs like a street circuit. That will typically have quite heavy knockoff springs fitted. Where if you go somewhere where top speed's really important, you typically don't want any extra drag on the straights. So the driver would pay a penalty by having knockoff springs, which means at the end of the long straights, and if there's any knockoff, they will have to pump the brake pedal up to get the pads to squeeze up against the disc. So when they're actually ready to brake, the car will brake as they're expecting. But the benefit of not having those knockoff springs is they'll have less parasitic drag with the discs. Will create a slight clearance between the pads and you'll have a slightly higher top speed. Another factor in controlling knockoff is the seal design. So the seals that seal the hydraulic pressure between the piston and the caliper also tend to have a small resistive force, and the amount of drag and the amount that the lips on those seals want to, the direction they want to tend to push the piston also has an effect on knockoff. So that was a short discussion on brake knockoff and some of the causes. In summary, if you've got brake knockoff problems with a long pedal when you go and approach the braking zone, particularly on bumpy circuits, what you need to do is to reduce the compliance in the system. So reducing wheel bearing clearance, making sure the whole thing's stiff enough, and if that's still fine and you can't do anything else to help that, you can try running anti-knockoff springs to get a better quality brake pedal. If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.